In this short video, we'll discuss theming in Codename One. We'll start with a bare-bones, native-style application to keep things simple. We'll start in the Designer tool. In the Designer tool, we can use the Native Theme option to see how our theme will look in iOS and Android. We can thus test the native feel of our theme. We can add a new entry to the theme by pressing the Add button. We can pick a theme entry from the combo box or type a custom entry. The Derive flag indicates if we want to inherit the appearance from the native theme. We can define many background image and gradient types, but now we'll focus on simpler things. I will create a green button with red foreground because my goal is to teach, not create something pretty. I can set the color by typing the color hex value into the respective entries or by using the color picker widget. I will also need to set the background to opaque, which is 255. 0 is transparent. I can pick the alignment of the text. Center is pretty common for buttons, so I'll use that. But I can align to the left and right too. Padding and margin can be defined in pixels, percentage units of the screen size, or millimeters. We always recommend using millimeters as it is consistently portable. This allows me to customize the size and spacing of the button. Don't be stingy with padding, as elements need to be big enough for touch interaction. There is a lot of confusion over padding and margin, so let's clarify this. Margin represents the space outside of the component, so you use that to push components away from one another or bring them closer together. Padding makes the component larger or smaller. It's the additional space within the component beyond what is normally needed to draw the component. I'll discuss border and derive soon. For now, we'll move directly to font. Fonts can be pretty complex. I recommend only using one of these native fonts, which will look decent on Android and iOS. You should usually size the native font in millimeters to avoid platform inconsistency. This looks great on iOS. Let's see how it looks on Android. That was totally surprising and unexpected. This happens because on Android, the button has a border. Let's edit the button entry. Border always takes precedence over other background types, so we should derive it and use an empty border if we don't want a border. That seems to have fixed it. But if we click the button, we see there is still a border for the selected style. We solve this by adding a new selected style for the button that derives from the unselected button and also overrides the border style with an empty option. The select style is effectively the focused state of the button. I use Command-C or Control-C on Windows to copy and paste the selected style into the pressed style. When I click the button, the problem is gone, but I don't see any effect either. I can edit the selected style of the button and pick a dark green color. I then go to do the same for the pressed style of the button. Once all that is done, pressing the button shows the correct highlighting, and all is good in the world once more. The code to show this is trivial, just a button added to a form. And this is how it looks on the simulator. Let's say we want to add a red button to the app. We'll just add a new theme entry and call it red button. We will then derive from button, so we will get a similar look. We will set the background to red and foreground to white, while leaving everything else in the default state. We'll copy and paste the red button style into the selected state. We'll leave everything as is and only change the background color to be a shade darker than the current red color by tuning it in the picker. Now we'll just paste this into pressed and go back to the IDE. We add the red button entry by creating a new button and adding it into the form. We use setUIID to set the theme entry ID to red button. We can also pass this to the button constructor as the second argument, but I wanted the code to be clearer. As you can see, the red button looks and acts like the green button. The cool thing is that you can apply a UIID to damn near anything. So I can apply the red button style to a text field through setUIID and get almost the same effect. As you can see, this is pretty close to the button appearance applied to a component that has completely different behavior. The theme can be manipulated directly from code in roughly the same way. We'll set the button color to blue by setting the background color of the red button's unselected style. Notice the pressed selected behavior of the new button is missing. We can fix this by changing the selected and pressed styles as well directly from code. I set them to the same color, so We don't see much, but you hopefully get my point. There is a better way though. By using getAllStyles, we can set the property on all styles in one swoop. One last subject is theme constants. With constants, we can manipulate many aspects of the theme. You can see them in the theme UI and look at the help text below each constant to understand what they are about. I suggest reading in the developer guide about the various options in the theme constants and theming in general. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and found it helpful.